Every day, I turn on the briefing from the White House and hear how amazing it is that companies are making 5 or 10 million masks. The other day, President Trump had one of the manufacturers there with him. Then he told us that that guy had told him about hospitals that used to order 10,000 at a time, but are now ordering a couple hundred thousand. The president, being who he is, immediately questioned whether most of those masks aren't somehow leaving through the back door. Good catch, Mr. Trump. You're pretty street smart for a billionaire. But what I was thinking is this. Why are we so focused on getting masks to healthcare workers while not wearing them ourselves? Have you seen the president or any of the task force wearing a mask? Neither have I. Here's Dr. Fauci on 60 Minutes.
Of confusion among people and misinformation surrounding face masks. Can you discuss that?
The masks are important for someone who's infected to prevent them from infecting someone else. Now, when you see people and look at the films in China and South Korea, whatever, everybody's wearing a mask. Right now in the United States, people should not be walking around with masks.
You're sure of it? Because people are listening really closely to this.
Right now, people should not be walking. There's no reason to be walking around with a mask. When you're in the middle of an outbreak, wearing a mask might make people feel a little bit better, and it might even block a droplet, but it's not providing the perfect protection that people think that it is. And often, there are unintended consequences. People keep fiddling with the mask, and they keep touching their face.
And can you get some schmutz sort of staying inside there?
Of course, of course. But when you think masks, you should think of healthcare providers needing them and people who are ill.
That makes no sense. He says that masks help prevent you from spreading the disease, but won't really prevent you from getting it. Oh yeah? So why is it so important that we have millions of masks for our healthcare workers? Do we think they have coronavirus? That we have to prevent them from giving it to patients? Of course not. These are the PPEs he's always talking about, the personal protective equipment. There's also this, the Surgeon General and the WHO, they really don't want us wearing masks. From the get-go with this thing, the CDC and everybody else have been telling us that we get COVID-19 through water droplets, but that the way to prevent it is by constantly washing your hands. Here's a page on the CDC's website. Person-to-person spread. Quote, the virus is thought to spread mainly from person to person, between people who are in close contact with one another, within about 6 feet, through respiratory droplets produced when an infected person coughs or sneezes. These droplets can land in the mouths or noses of people who are nearby or possibly be inhaled into the lungs. Unquote. But a mask won't help? Interesting. What about surfaces? Same page. Spread from contact with contaminated surfaces or objects. Quote, it may be possible that a person can get COVID-19 by touching a surface or object that has the virus on it and then touching their own mouth, nose, or possibly their eyes. But this is not thought to be the main way the virus spreads. Unquote. So why the constant hand washing? If doctors and nurses are wearing masks, it must be to stop those water droplets. Why the hell are the rest of us supposed to steer clear of masks and just compulsively wash our hands? Are they expecting us to believe that these droplets are landing on our fingers? We inhale like a Hoover 12 to 20 times a minute, but it's our hands we have to worry about? Something is wrong with this picture. I grew up in San Gabriel, California. We didn't know any Asians when I was a kid, but now San Gabriel and the surrounding towns, Alhambra, Monterey Park, San Marino, and Arcadia are all Asian majority or close to it. My mom was a realtor, and it was a given since the mid-80s that nearly all of her listings sold to Asian immigrants, mostly coming from Taiwan. I still go down that way now and then. Even before the COVID scare, you couldn't help noticing that these folks wear masks if there is anything in the air, from pollen to pandemics. It's been a thing with upscale Asians for a long time. This is a chart from a website called masksavelives.org. This shows the trajectory of COVID-19 growth in many countries. With the exception of China, the countries circled in red are non-mask-wearing cultures. The ones in blue are mask-wearing cultures. Does it look to you like masks are ineffective? Here's a comparison they made. I checked the numbers and they're correct. This next thing is an animated graph from ourworldanddata.org. That goes by pretty fast. Let's watch it again. Keep your eye on the top few spots. You'll see that all of the mask-wearing cultures spent some time in second place early on, but got a handle on the virus very quickly. China got taken unawares. I think the virus took root in workers from the countryside, and maybe it took them a while to get into masks. But now they too have fallen way down in the COVID pack. Coincidence? Maybe they're just washing their hands more than we are. Look, I'm not a scientist. I'm just a guy stuck at home while all my friends are losing their jobs and their businesses. I'm not one of the smart guys like Dr. Fauci, but I know when somebody is trying to con me. Fauci says that masks don't keep you safe, but that it's vitally important to get masks to our frontline people for their safety. He assumes that you and I won't catch the contradiction. I see people all the time with masks now, Asians and non-Asians alike. Many of those masks are homemade. You can't buy them anywhere, and if you have some, the task force wants you to donate them. I see several reasons to wear one beyond their obvious utility in blocking water droplets. Contrary to what Fauci says, adjusting a face mask does not cause you to touch your mouth and nose. It prevents you from touching your mouth and nose. I know. I wore a dust mask probably 100 days a year as a house painter. If we were to take a few million of the new American-made masks and get them to working people, we could open up the country again. Everybody would wear a mask, and the sight of the thing on your fellow workers would remind you that we're all still keeping our distance. And when you got an itchy nose and couldn't scratch it, that would be a reminder to wash up. And with your nice clean hands, you could scratch your nose and put the thing back on again. If you did sneeze, your mask would catch it even better than your elbow. How could this possibly hurt? If this makes sense to you, please share this with a friend and tell us what you think in the comments below. If you haven't yet joined our Common Sense family, please take a second to subscribe. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and then click the little bell to get notifications.